little TV production while we're here. So we have some introductions that we'd like to do, and what we need from you guys is your support and enthusiasm. Hey, Ray Lucero, will you step out here and let everybody see you? You guys, this is Ray Lucero. He's our floor manager. Okay, Ray is going to be giving you the cue for applause. And basically what I'm going to do is introduce Jerry Jeff Walker, and he'll tell you when to applaud, and we'll do a couple of intros, and we'll be on our way with Michael Johnson. Thanks, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jerry Jeff Walker.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Tonight we got a special treat. We've got a singer-songwriter. He's one of my very favorites. I've been trying to get him down here to Austin for quite a while. Let's have a big Texas Connection welcome for Michael Johnson.
Welcome to your own town. I'm going to take a minute and get tuned up here. It's too quiet, you know? There's a lot of water flowing under this bridge. There's a voice inside me saying, get your feet wet. 'Cause that's that. I can scream, I can shout, I can cry my eyes out, but she's not coming. Carved out our names. In the morning I am gonna cut that tree down. Gonna build a fire and watch us go up in flames. And that's that. I can scream, I can shout, I can tear my hair out, but she's not gonna.
She's still gone.
she's not coming back. And that's there. Yeah, that's there. Oh, that's there. And that's there. Yeah, that's there. Oh, that's there.
And that's that. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here. Please make welcome my good friends. This is Jack Sundrud, and this is Russ Paul. Thank you. Russ Paul's back. Yes, they're from a group called Great Plains. And if you haven't heard of them, you're going to. You probably will. So here's a song which I just learned off my latest album. That's an old line, but I use it anyway. It's called Half the Moon. Well, thank you. Which I wrote about 20 years ago. Just Jack and I just got around to finishing it here recently. Thank you. Thank you. There are other ways to look at the human condition, I'm sure. I don't know what they are, though. There's a lot of love songs. Love songs that say forever or never. And there aren't hardly any love songs that say, well, maybe. Maybe not. And I try to stay away from the songs that say forever, because there's a lot of them, but this one, I had no choice. It's called Unconditionally. This one again.
Take two.
Thank you anyway. Thank you very much. I appreciate
maybe
it.
Maybe have a two-thirds applause on this one.
Not unless you're sure.
We love you unconditionally.
Right. So here's a little song called Me and God Are Watching Scotty Grow. It's awfully Austin, Texas of you. I'm sorry, I made that up. Actually, I didn't. That's another vaudeville line, I think. Okay, so here we go again.
Same song?
No. Yes, it's the same song, but it's in a new key, and I'm not going to tell you what it is.
Why should I be
Thank you. Thank you.
Is there a little something to sip on here? Clear Budweiser.
I can't. I'm on.
Thank you. Stage cups, yes.
Here's a very unpopular theme, this next song. That's why I jumped on it right away. Seems like, you know, there's just so many, especially in country music, though, there's so many songs about, oh, that man of mine is just such a bimbo, you know, she says, and he drinks and he plays around and he comes home. But I love that man of mine, you know. But you just can't do that the other way. I mean, you can't say that bimbet. I mean, it's not just that it doesn't translate that way. It's just not a very popular theme these days. So now that I've lost half of the audience, this song is called Is She Worth the Trouble? Well, that's pretty much our show. Thanks for coming down, folks. Well, thank you. We lived. It's the first time we've made it through that one, I think.
Yes, it is.
Okay, I think we're
going to
do an interview now.
Yes. Okay. Great day in Austin today,
hey? It's a beauty.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
I've been on the shows. I've been trying to weave a little bit of a history of where people's music kind of came from. So we'll start with
Music in the family? Did people sing?
Mom? For sure. Absolutely. Dad? Yeah. Player piano. Nobody really played the piano, but we stood around it.
Oh, great.
Yeah. Yeah. It was fun. We sang 12th Street Rag. In fact, my mom's favorite song is the Johnson Rag. You know.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Is there words to it?
No. Well, yeah. I mean, I don't remember what they are. But
yeah, there are words to it, though.
Johnson Rag. Johnson Rag.
Okay.
We all came in right right on time.
Did it.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, we always had a lot of music around our house. I always thought everybody did that, and I found out a lot of people didn't. But most of the musicians that come through did have it.
Yeah, I think that's got to be true.
Yeah. And so how did you get started going maybe out of the house with the music?
Well, I moved to the garage.
Since you couldn't take the player piano with you, I assume you...
Yeah, I moved to the garage when I was 13.
Uh-huh.
And I lived next to my car for a long time. Actually, I had a car at age 13, but it was a 50 Ford. But that's another story. Uh-huh. Anyway, I lived in the garage, and it was great because I got to play with tape recorders, and I got to stay up till as long as I possibly could.
Uh-huh.
And as soon as I could do that, I began sneaking girls into the garage.
Not old enough to drive, but to go parking.
That's about it. Yeah, yeah.
You must have been a smooth talker to get him in the car to, you know.
Well, it was... Yeah,
well, I couldn't get.
You
want to
go for a stop? Just kind of sit there.
Yeah. Little world of your own in the garage,
yeah.
Hey?
Yeah.
I had an attic that did the same thing, where I moved up to in the upstairs and built my little room, and yep. Like you say, kind of controlling your own world.
Yeah, it's heaven. Isn't it? There's a lot of little kids that have to do that, I'm sure, just to have that space.
Yeah. So the music out there. Just kept picking, playing a little bit?
Yeah, I just didn't know. I kept thinking, you know, there's going to come this time when I'm going to wonder what I do for a living, or what I'm going to do. Is it, you know, I'm going to...
I can hardly wait.
Oh, man. You know, I know it. I'm thinking, is it rug shampooing or aluminum siding sometime? You know? But
I take notes, you know, when I see somebody like, you know, any fool rents you a car or something, I go,
yeah.
That's one I can do. I'll write that down in
yeah.
case this all goes away.
Yeah. I'm still working on my, would you like fries with that?
Yeah. Most people say, you know, keep on playing. I go, I can't do anything else. So,
no.
You know, that's how I will.
Yeah, moving and storage would be good for that.
I already did that one.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I lasted 3 days. The guy left me at some house, the other driver.
Yeah.
I've been staying at other people's houses ever since. So the music, we start wandering around with it?
I started wandering
once
around.
Once you got the car to go?
Wherever I could. As soon as I could drive, I did. And I played at school, and I played, you know, like most musicians, I never learned how to dance because I was on stage all the time. And,
uh-huh.
I don't know. Then I started playing bars as soon as I could, sooner than I was supposed to. And,
mm-hmm.
This
in Minneapolis?
From there 20 years later. No, this was in Denver. I'm a Denver boy.
Okay, I knew there was a folk scene thing up there. But so you're coming out of Denver.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, good. That's a good music town.
Oh, yeah, Denver was great. It was fine. And it was the folky stuff. And I've had kind of three careers, I guess, other than the... Well, I did lead ponies around in a circle once at an amusement park, but I don't count that.
Pony,
I
also pony bit me.
We've led the same life.
Yeah, really. That's how we got here.
I was an usher in a stag movie theater for a while, too.
Didn't get that one.
That's...
No, there's no ushers honestly. In stag movie theater.
Well, not stag... Not stag... How would you know?
Not the ones I was in, anyway.
Not stag. Not hardcore, we're talking. It's like adult movie theaters.
Oh, no.
And I just walked around...
This is getting more complicated than I thought.
Yes, it is, indeed. So I just, you know, walked around with a flashlight and told a bunch of guys to cut it out. I did. I just say, hey, cut it out.
Nothing personal. Sorry, sir.
All right. So you said you first ran across me in Houston in the 60s?
Yeah. I don't know whose house we were at.
I don't either.
But, yeah, you and I and my brother PJ and Guy Clark was there. And we wound up.
PJ's Spain. Your brother.
Yeah, PJ's my brother.
Boy, I'm a quick learner. I didn't know that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we've been brothers.
He had the other car, yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, okay, now it all goes back. Yeah, there was a scene there. That I liked that period of time when there was coffee houses and a lot of people swapping songs and really looking at songs really hard. You know, we wanted a lot out of them at that time.
Yeah.
And it was fun to have everybody care about them. And
Yeah, that was wonderful stuff. A lot of coffee houses, a lot of miles in the road. And back when it was so simple, you could hop out of your Carmen Ghia, let's say.
Yeah.
Which is what I drive, 74 Carmen Ghia. And just pull your guitar case out, and that's all you had. Uh-huh. Right? Then you'd go to the gig, and you sit down and do it. And it's not like that anymore.
No. Can't even afford a Carmen Ghia anymore. Oh. If you didn't get it in 74, you won't get it now, right? So what led the trail to Nashville? Just keep following the music? And
no, there was a guy named Gene Cotton. Have you heard of him? He does great work. He's
I can't even remember your brother. How am I going to remember Gene Cotton?
That's true. I should remember that.
Yeah.
Right? I'm talking to a guy who has no memory here, so. No.
That's what makes me ask so many questions. But anyway, so Gene got you to go.
It's nice. It's nice that way, though.
I have no preconclusions about anything.
Yeah. So Gene called me up, and he found one of my early records in a bargain bin and said, I want you to come to Nashville and play on my record. And I walked in to the studio, and there was there was Brent Mayer, a great producer, Steve Gibson, Jack Williams, Kenny Malone. I mean, names that have become really famous as session players. Mm-hmm. And these guys were just all sitting there. It's like I fell out of bed and landed in this other world. And I played, and I asked Brent if he'd be interested in maybe trying to do something for me for no money, kind of, you know? And he said, sure. He had no reason to say that at all. And that's kind of how it began. And I'm still making records with exactly the same people, with a few exceptions, with those same people.
Well, that's lucky.
So, yeah, it's been really lucky. It's been another family.
Was Bluer Than Blue in some of that early working?
Yeah. Bluer Than Blue. I remember when I first heard that, I couldn't believe that. I didn't write that. I pretend that I wrote that. I tell people that I wrote that, but I...
Well, you brought it to light. That's as important.
Yeah.
Can we have a little piece of it?
Sure. Let's see. 'Cause I'm bluer than blue, sadder than sad. You're the only light this empty room has ever had. Edited for television. Life without you is gonna be...
What color?
Bluer than blue. And then I wrote... No, I don't.
Thanks.
But yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Just throwing those notes away. My favorite one, of course, is I Gotta Get a Trail on The Moon Is Still Over His Shoulder. But where did that come from?
That came from a man whose songs I have loved, and I still record a lot of his work. His name is Hugh Prestwood. Mm-hmm. Great music. Yeah, he wrote this song. You want to hear a chorus?
Sure, I would love to. This is one of those. I have that weird curse, but whenever I stop and like something, it's like, great, you know, then it kind of just doesn't seem to be there as much. If I hear one, I go, well, I'll never hear that again. I hear it for months, you know.
Yeah,
so
I know.
They ought to run records by me, I guess, and if I just don't like them, they'll be hits all the way forever.
The reverse.
This one here is just so pretty, the sentiment and the melody, and it's just ought to be the standard forever.
Sure.
I'm still learning it. I'm going to watch closely.
I'll sing a chorus for
you,
if I can. And the moon is still over her shoulder, and the ribbon is still in her hair. And he can still see her dancing, and the music is still in. Sometimes he finds it's amazing that all of his children are well, when their mother, she is still turning 18 and turning
the stars are still falling above. And she never gets 1 minute older. And he is still falling.
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Good song.
Yeah. Thank you.
Well, that's the thing that we were, when we had Richard Lee on a show here, I was saying that if country music is going to be our pop music now, as they're saying, with Garth having the number one album on the whole music scene, then we need to have these standards if we're going to fill up the gap of where all the standards are being sung. And those kind of melodies and those kind of things have to be sung to get into our repertoires, you know?
Well, we need the new standards, I guess, you know, because we still
need the pretty ballads and the pretty words.
Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain, it's, you know. Mm-hmm. And what a thing to mention to Richard Lee, of course, because...
Yeah, he writes those pretty melodies.
Brown eyes blue.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So it's nice that you're the balladeer that we have now to sing the ballads, the pretty songs.
Oh, yeah. I'm hopeless.
Hopeless romantic?
Yeah.
Well, it's nice. It fits with the acoustic guitar and everything. And thanks for coming down to Texas finally and singing them with us.
Anytime, Jerry.
All right, good. Let's get on with it.
No standing, no standing.
Okay, we're just going to reset right here, and then Michael is going to come back on. Ray will give you the cue when it's time. Y'all remember Ray Lucero now. Hey, Ray. Ray can't hear very well tonight, so y'all scream at him if he's not paying attention.
Favorite frog man, you all know. He's got a black wetsuit and he's ready to go. He's got a mini sub and he don't care, no. He don't ever come up for air, cause it's Jacques Cousteau. How low, baby, can you go? From sea to shining sea, he's checking them out for you and me. Tank on his back, strapped and locked. He's got goggles and flippers and he's ready to rock. And he shoots the fishies one by one, only with the camera, never the gun. Jacques Cousteau, how low, baby, can you go? From sea to shining sea, he's checking them out for you and me. Magnifique, Pacific, terrifique. He's a friend of the whale and a friend of the shark and all the little fishies that glow in the dark. Well, Jacques and the fishes, they're doing the swim. I said, jump back, Jacques, and do it again. He don't work no 9 to 5. He says, c'est la vie. He take another dive. Jacques Cousteau, how low, baby, can you go? From sea to shining sea, he's checking them out for you, baby. Me. Mm-hmm.
favorite part. He said, scuba dooba, scuba doo-wa, scuba dooba doo-wa. He said, scuba dooba, scuba doo-wa, yeah, scuba dooba doo-wa. He said, scuba dooba, scuba doo-wa, scuba dooba doo-wa. He said, scuba dooba, scuba doo-wa, yeah, scuba dooba doo-wa. Thank you. Well, here's a song that I'm happy to say was a hit record for me. And for a while, I used to dedicate this song to every woman who ever wanted to go back to school or to go to the Himalayas or to be a mom or to be a chef or to open a restaurant or whatever it was that she wanted to do. But for some reason, somebody else in her life maybe was a little jealous or scared or proud or something and lobbied against it, shall we say. And she said, okay, I won't. And then every time I would make that dedication, of course, it would get real quiet. And so I don't anymore. What gifts can I bring you to prove that my love for you is true? I want to make you mine forever. There's nothing on this earth I would not do. She said, anything I want, you have given willingly. So now there's only one more thing I need. If you love, give me wings. Don't be afraid if I fly. A bird in a cage will forget how to sing. If you love me, give me wings. He walked over to the window, silently stared into space. He said, I just want to protect you, 'cause this world is a dangerous place. She put her arms around him and she said, I know you mean well, but there's lessons I must learn for myself. So if you love, trust me, so give me wings. And she said, up above the clouds, you can see forever. And I know you and I can learn to fly together. If you love me, afraid if I fly, the bird
give me wings. And if you really love me, give me wings. Give me wings.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks. Thank you very much. Well, this is a nice crowd. You guys are fine. So where do you hang out? Here. Good for you.
Mind if we come over?
Yeah, if I lived here, I'd be here. But... oh, never mind. We're going to close out. This will be our little swan song. And we're going to close out with a truck driving song. And there have been so many wonderful truck driving songs throughout history, like...
Convoy.
And that's just to name a few. Convoy and... This song is about what it's like to try to drive a tractor trailer from Kingsport, Tennessee to Baltimore and back on a round trip, which is foolhardy because it's vertical as well as horizontal. And so it was only fitting that the song originally was called Up Too Slow, Down Too Fast, but the record company said, oh, no, 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 no. They said, people will misunderstand, which obviously some of them have. So now it's called Inagada da Vida. Sunshine of Your Love. It's called Roller Coaster Run. I ride a roller coaster up and down an asphalt track. Runs from Kingsport, Tennessee to Baltimore and back. I drive the Blue Ridge Mountains in an 18-year-old truck. Takes a little cheating and it takes a little luck. And it's up too slow and it's down too fast. Chills higher than the last on this roller coaster run. One day there, one day back, one day with my wife. Late at night we talk about our roller coaster life. Seems to me when going up the law should be obeyed, but you got to come down flying if you want to make the grade. And it's up too slow and it's down too fast. When will I be done? And each hill's higher than the last on this roller coaster. It's down too fast. When will I be? Each hill's higher than the last on this roller coaster run.
day there, one day back, roller coaster life. Up too slow, down too fast, roller coaster, roller coaster. One day there, one day back, roller coaster life.
Thank you. Russ Paul. Jack Sundrud. Thank you very much.
Michael Johnson.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. The beer's on the house. Thank you very much.
We want you all to stay seated right in here. We're going to.
Okay, everybody stay put if you would, please. Don't run out. Please stay put. We have just these two small outros to do, little TV bits. Jerry Jeff's going
to
go and sit in different places in the audience. And if you would, please, just kind of hang out with us for, two or three more minutes. Won't take long.
Didi, can you slide just a little bit around the chair that way? Can you get me from here?
Yeah.
It just did, yes. Yeah, right. But I mean, like, just a second ago. Uh-huh. I see. Stand by.
Let's hear it for Jerry
Jeff. Yeah. Thank you.
So we have someone here from Montreal, Canada.
Right.
You enjoy Michael Johnson?
He was terrific.
Good, really thanks.
Had a good time.
Well, we had a great time. I hope you enjoyed Michael Johnson, and tune into the Texas Connection next week. Thank you. Okay, good. All right, we had to get... We had a great time here with my good buddy John Prine. We'll see you next week on the Texas Connection. Thank you.
Okay, everybody, you can go. Thanks for hanging out. Come back in about 15 minutes and we'll bring back John Prine.